Well, I don't have much else to do right now, so I figure I'd share my knowledge of two-stroke diesel engines. It's actually not as complicated as you might think, but definitely different from the normal two-stroke engine. So, here's a very nice basic picture of one. Yeah, it is paper. I don't own an actual Detroit diesel engine, but this will do it pretty good, probably better than what I would do looking at a real engine, because then, you know, this just simplifies it. Well, anyway, here we got all the strokes, or all the parts of stroke, I should say. You got a blower, you got your piston, crankshaft, you got a valve. That's unusual for two strokes, but this ain't your normal two stroke, it's diesel. You got your air intake ports, your exhaust port, and your fuel injector. Now, these are always going to be on the engine. Supercharged two strokes are considered naturally aspirated. You won't run without the supercharger. And that's because that's how it gets its air. Because on a normal engine, your intake valve opens and your piston's going down, sucking in air. Well, on this, the air ports are open. It doesn't have valve, it has like air ports in the cylinder liner. It's like a whole bunch of holes at the bottom. So when the piston comes down, it uncovers those ports, and then the blower blows all the air into it. And at the same time, the exhaust valve is open, and that blows out all the exhaust gases. Then the piston comes back up, those ports are covered, and that valve shuts. Then you have compression right there. See, now your ports are shut, valve is closed, and now we're getting some compression in here. Eventually it reaches top dead center, and now it's spraying in some fuel and it's beginning to ignite. Of course, not very much after it starts doing its power stroke. The exhaust valve opens, it starts on its exhaust stroke, and it's not at the bottom yet, but once it reaches the bottom, that blower is going to blow all the exhaust air and it's going to do it all over again. Sorry for the camera work. And that's pretty much what it does. Now, these engines may sound like they rev up a lot, but they really don't. In fact, I don't think many of them will go past 2,000 RPM. They just sound like they're revving really high because it's a two-stroke engine, but that is the very basics of how one would run. So I guess I'll go through it again if you didn't really catch it. Bottom dead center, blower's blowing in all the air, exhaust valve is open at the same time, blowing out all the exhaust. And there's your intake. Here's the compression. Piston's going up, ports are covered, valve is shut. Now we're getting compression. And we're reaching the power stroke where it's at top dead center, fuel's injected, and it sends the piston down, and it starts on this exhaust stroke, valve is open, and ports are about to open, and then we start again at the intake. And that is the very basics of how a two-stroke diesel engine would run. Now, a lot of them will have a turbocharger to go along to feed air to the supercharger. Yeah, that's pretty common to see. As far as power, these engines, a lot of people don't think they make a lot of power. The thing is, they do make a lot of power. It's just the power band is really small. I think it's around midway through 600 RPM. I think that's where the power band is, and it doesn't go much farther after that. So what they did is they come up with this two-stick transmission, and to keep it into its power range, you can't lug with these engines at all. But if you stay in that sweet spot of the power band, these things can make a lot of power. And I mean a lot. Now, as far as names, you might see something like 6V92, then maybe a T. Well, here I'll explain what that means. It means it's a six-cylinder in a V shape, so it's a V6. That 92 means it's 92 cubic inches per cylinder. And that T means it's turbocharged. Okay, and then you got maybe like a 453T. Well, pretty much the same thing, except there's no V. That means it's an inline four, 53 cubic inches per cylinder with a turbocharger. And, you know, you could keep going on, like, 12V92, 8V92, I think there was an 8V53T, you know. That's pretty much what the names mean. Now, again, I don't actually own a Detroit diesel. As far as reliability, it's a little iffy. They're pretty nasty engines. They're no longer made because they do not comply with emission systems. But, you know, like the heads, there wasn't really a head gasket. It was like a whole bunch of seals and pieces and everything. And, you know, another big problem was fuel lines would often be inside the valve cover. So when they leaked, you get fuel in your oil and that causes total destruction. And so, you know, it was kind of iffy. As far as what these engines were mostly used in, they were used in pretty much everything from tractors to big rigs and, of course, ships. I think they were most popular in the ships because you could run these engines backwards. And that was really helpful when you had two propellers. So, you know, you have an equal balance. So the propellers to spin them both one direction, you have them spin in opposite directions, and you could spin the engine backwards. So that is pretty much the basics of a two-stroke Detroit diesel. So I'll show you the pictures one more time. Yeah, pretty basic. And that is your Detroit diesel two-stroke engine.